say that would be interesting. So, how are you?
I'm fine.
Who's first?
I'll kick things off. So, you're out right in season 5.
Yeah, I'm actually, I spent last night, instead of going out to the parties, I'm supposed to go to Woodstock to see Will and all these friends and all that. I was actually in my room with half my staff and Bruce Miller, my co-star, when I break into season finale, because I'm writing that right now for season 5, which will air sometime next.
Has there been any talk about season 6 yet?
Lots of talk about season 6, and fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed?
Fingers crossed.
And another, are they looking more at another 13 episode or another split?
I don't know exactly.
Yeah, okay.
I
mean,
the split is killing you.
Well, I don't think that they want to split anymore, because obviously that was sort of not well received by the audience, and it's hard on us for a scheduling situation. I mean, this is season 4.5, as they call it, but it's season 6 in terms of our actual yearly airing cycles, and we're right now writing what is going to be season 7 in terms of the years that we've been on the air. So it would be nice to kind of try to get things back into some sense of normalcy.
So going back to season 4.5 / season 6,
yeah, right.
Assuming you can kind of remember it at this point.
I can.
What are the sort of the big teasers that for people to be on the lookout for this year?
Well, we've got obviously the continuing ramifications of the timeline change for our characters, and they are adjusting to those changes in their personal lives. There are new discoveries about themselves and each other that will continue to play out. And the way that they react and sort of decide what they're going to do in terms of their new jobs and their new relationships is going to get very interesting. And then we have this sort of backbone of this mission being given to Eureka. We've got amazing guest stars, Ming-Na and Stan Lee and Dave Foley, and obviously Felicia Day and Will Wheaton. And that will be something that sort of pits our scientists against each other as they're competing to be a part of it. And then all of the technology that has to actually be developed by the people in Eureka to make this mission happen. So it's really interesting. And of course, there's going to be a conspiracy element, as we saw with Beverly Barlow after this last episode, that Beverly has just sort of taken Allison, and we don't know exactly what's going to happen.
Is there going to be, with the timeline change, is that going to kind of become less of an issue as the series goes on, but still continue to be part of it, or how is that going to play out a little bit?
I think that the really heavy delving into it has happened in the first half of the season, and the second half is more about adjusting to life now, and that way it's not, you know, every episode isn't about another giant timeline shift discovery, but it's something that becomes a part of their lives. I mean, there will be more discoveries along the way about themselves over the whole course of the season, but it's more about this mission, and then the individual stories that come out of, you know, some aspects of this project that's been given to them that will sort of fuel the storylines.
What's
the
Zane and Joe story? You know, I know from a conference call he said it's kind of something that's going to drag out for a while, but is it moving in a positive direction?
It depends, I guess, on whether you want them to get together or not.
I do. So
we get some thumbs up. I think that there is a connection that they have that is undeniable, and there is also a reason that Joe said no when he proposed, or couldn't answer, I should say, that she froze. And that voice in the back of her head is making her question diving right back into something with someone who is very different now. I mean, he's sort of the bad boy Zane that he was when he first came to Eureka. So do you want to go through that whole process again with somebody not knowing whether or not you should have said yes or no to their proposal to begin with? It's messy. And I think that one of the things that we really tried to embrace in terms of storytelling is that our stories, I think that for us in season 3, 3.5, that for a number of reasons that we got into a little bit too much of an episodic nature without real ongoing ramifications each week. And we wanted there to be stakes that carried on. And that's one of the reasons why the reset is something that we didn't want to just fix. And it's the same thing with these relationships, that life is messy and our relationships are messy, and so we're embracing them.
I'm blanking on Allison's son's name right now.
Kevin,
thank you. I really like where you're going with this character. You're making him very, very interesting in a way you couldn't really do before.
Yeah.
And place that we're saying you want to go. And you have plans to kind of flesh that character out.
So yeah, Kevin continues to grow and evolve and become his own man. And that's hard for Allison to deal with. As a mom who was...
And that actor, by the way.
The actor, yeah. I mean, Trevor Jackson is a remarkable talent. Singer, dancer, writer, actor. I mean, he's like Michael Jackson on steroids, you know, having him on the show. But he is he's an incredible performer, which allows us to write more for him. And the character is interesting. Allison was used to having a son who really was dependent on her in ways. And that even though she really wished that she could connect with him more, as I think, you know, most parents that I know and a lot of our staff has very direct relationships with people with autism or with children with autism. My wife is an expert in the field with all of her doctoral research and working with kids with autism. We were very careful in how we wanted to approach this. But there's that... what you feel when we always feel human is that you wish that you could connect in a way that you couldn't. And so what happens when all of a sudden she can, but he's not really interested? You know, all of a sudden he's this sort of normal, rebellious teenager. He's like, Mom, get off. I want to go to Dre's house and hang out with my Xbox. I get it. You love me. It's enough. And she's kind of a back on her heels. What do I do? Do I trust this? Do I just let him go? How do I deal with this? And it puts her in a unique position as a single mom with a very high demanding job that we wanted to be able to really explore both sides of the curriculum.
Have you ever considered doing flashbacks to a new TV show, so to show either... so in other words, before the characters got back, what their lives were like. Do you follow me? So, you know, to see what the terminology here is difficult, but if you follow me, the universe to Fargo was like, what were the secret things they don't know that they did.
What was he like before he replaced himself and
exactly,
all of a sudden he was not the tyrant Fargo?
Right.
We don't have any plans for that specifically, because I think just like how you were trying to describe it, it could be very challenging.
It's very clear in my head, and I
understand.
To describe it, and it just falls apart.
And then you have to think about how you would write that and shoot that. So, it's an interesting idea. I think that we have been doing that more through other characters.
Right.
That other characters and their reactions to them in certain ways, or telling them something about them that they didn't know. There's something that's about to come up for Allison in the next episode. It might be actually the one that's on the screen tonight, where she learns something about herself from Felicia Day's character, Holly Martin. And she had no idea. But what she knows is that it was something that she had always dreamed of doing in the alternate timeline, but it was the road not taken. And in this timeline, she did take that road.
She went to space camp?
Maybe. So you have some space camp potentially to look forward to. So and it's really awesome. That's an episode that really does feature Will Wheaton as well and Felicia Day that I've wanted to do for such a long time, which is get to see who these people were as kids before they grew up. And that's something that we're going to get to do in this back half, at least the back half of the season.
I love Holly.
Felicia's amazing. I mean, there are certain actors like Will, like Felicia, like Wally Shawn, who just fit the show. And you wonder how they actually were on the show to begin with. You're just glad that you can kind of grab them. And she's perfect. She's just, it was great to be able to create that role for her. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.
Thanks
so much.